In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to create this pretty cool animated camera viewfinder overlay inside Adobe After Effects. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Before we get into the tutorial, I just want to say if you are a patron on my Patreon page, as always, you can download this MoGurt file to use inside Premiere Pro down in the link below. If you're not a patron, consider supporting me by joining. You can download this asset as well, and along with a lot of other cool things that I've created. All right, now let's dive in and see how to create this from scratch inside Adobe After Effects. So I'm inside Adobe After Effects, and to get started, I'm just gonna go up to Composition, New Composition. I'm gonna name my composition. I'm just gonna name it Camera Viewfinder Overlay. And then from the preset, I'm just gonna choose 1920 by 1080, 29 frames a second. If you want a different resolution, you can choose another one as well. I'm gonna stick to 29 frames a second, square pixels. I'm gonna leave it also at 1 minute long, but as always, you can change this to however long you wish. And then I'm gonna click OK. So the first part that we're gonna create is the border. So to do that, I simply use shape layers. To set this up, I'm gonna turn on the title action safe by clicking this button down here. Just click on this and turn on title action safe. We're gonna draw the borders on the very outside of the lines. So to get started, I'm gonna grab my pen tool, and then from the top section here, what we have to do is disable fill. So I'm gonna click on the fill button, click the hash, and then click OK. And then I'm gonna enable stroke by clicking on the stroke button, going to solid color, clicking OK, and then changing the color and the pixels to white and 4 pixels, which it is already on, so we're good there. So next, what I'm gonna do is start to draw out kind of where I want the border to be. So to do that, I'm just gonna simply click once, hold down shift to create a straight line, click again, and then click once more. Now I'm gonna click off. Now if you need to make adjustments, what you can do is zoom in here, and you can see we're just a little bit off the hash. So I'm just gonna click and drag while holding down shift to get it to the corner there. You can check your points, make sure they're all lined up. In this case, they are. All right, so now that we're good, I'm gonna zoom out, go back to fit view, and now we have to duplicate this and put it in the other corners. To do that, I'm first gonna rename it so we stay organized. So I'm gonna hit return. I'm just gonna name this top left corner. And then I'm gonna duplicate it by hitting Command D. I'm gonna rename this new layer top right corner. All right, so to get it to the other side, what I'm gonna do is hit S on the keyboard. And we're gonna break the link and kind of reorient the way this layer is. So I'm gonna click the link button and then change the X value to negative 100. And you'll notice this kind of flips its horizontal axis here. Now what we can do is click P to bring up position. And I'm gonna click and drag the X value all the way to the other side. So you can see we just placed it on this side. And if you want, you can toggle off title action safe to kind of see what we have so far. So it should look something like this. Now that we have the top, an easy way to put these on the bottom as well is to select both of these layers, hit Command D, I'm gonna put them above. I'm just gonna hit R to bring up rotation. I'm just gonna rotate this 180 degrees for both, and then click P to bring up position, and then bring the Y position down. I'm gonna turn back on title action safe so that we can see it. Just turn it, just kind of get it lined up there. Once they're good, we just need to flip that one more time. So I'm gonna click on this one. I'm gonna first rename it by going and clicking on return. I'll name this bottom left corner. And then I'm gonna click S, and then I'm gonna break the link and then just flip the horizontal axis by changing the first value to negative 100. And that kind of flips it back. Same with the other, I'm gonna click on the other, rename it, click S, and we'll change this back to 100. Now we have our completed border. Okay, so now that we have our border, what I'm gonna do next is create the time code. There's two different ways that you can do this. I'm gonna show you both ways, but one way has more advantages than the other, which I'm gonna show you shortly. All right, so to get started, I'm gonna go up to layer, new solid. Either way, you're gonna create a new solid. I'm just gonna name this time code. Once you have the new solid, doesn't really matter what color it is, just click okay. We're gonna look at the two different effects. So if we go up to effect, text, there's two different options here. First, there's time code. So if we click on time code, you can see it displays a time code in the top left. This is what I used in the MoGurt pack. And you can see you have very advanced settings in the top left where you can change the source to custom, and you can really customize the time units, the starting frame, the drop frame, and it's really much a time code control effect. So that's what I use in the Mogurt. But the downside of using this effect is that you can't display custom text. So for example, you can't change this text to a different font. You're kind of stuck to the way it looks here. Now you can customize a few of the appearance options down below. You can turn off the box, for example. You can uncheck composite to original, and you can see that we have it now in our composition. You can see the border that we just created. So this is one option. Then all you would really do is just kind of realign this into the center. Now it doesn't need to be at the top center, but most cases that's typically where it is. It can also be in the bottom center as well, or in the corners, whichever you prefer. But this is essentially how you would create that. And then if you go forward in time, you can see it's picking up the time controls. But this is beneficial if you're working at 60 frames a second specifically. So say if this composition was 60 frames per second, you can change the time units to 60, or maybe even 120 if we're, you know, in a higher frame rate as well. And you can see if we go out forward in time that the frames are actually counting up to 60 before it changes to the next second. So that's how to do it if you're in a high frame rate, but the downside is you can't change the font. You're kind of limited here. Now the other way to do it, the way that if you want to be a little bit more customizable, but you won't have as much time code control, is using the numbers effect. So if we take a look at the numbers effect, we'll go to effect, text, numbers, you can change the font. So that's the big difference here. For example, the font I use, which I will link down in the video description, it's called Mundial. And then you have different alignment options. I'm gonna center align it and click OK. And you can see this is much more than just a time code effect here. So for example, I'm just gonna change the fill color to white. I'm gonna scale this up here. And from the type, you have these three different time code options. So you have 30, 24, and 25. As you can see, 60 is not an option here. So if you're working on 29, you could use this effect, or 24 or 25, and you have customizability when it comes to the font. Now, one other thing in this effect, I'm gonna turn off proportional spacing. If you don't, you'll notice that it kind of bounces on the x-axis quite a bit. So I'm gonna uncheck that and then turn up the tracking. So those are the two different ways to get this effect. Choose whichever one, you know, floats your boat or floats your goat, but that's how you would create the time code effect inside After Effects. Either way, I'm gonna move this up so that we have it here. And similar to the other time code, you can offset the value, and that's right here. So say if you wanted to start it a few minutes in the future, say if you've been recording for a while, that's how you would change that. But essentially, that's pretty much how to create the time code. All right, so now that we have our time code and I showed you the two different ways, let's set up the record button. Now this is pretty cool. I'm gonna show you how to set up a blinking light and then also how to loop it. So this is gonna be beneficial if you're seeing how to loop layer keyframes inside After Effects. All right, so to get started, what I'm gonna do is grab my shape tool. I'm gonna click and long hold to bring up the ellipse tool. So now that we have that selected, I'm gonna go to my fill. Once again, we have to enable it. So I'm gonna click on fill, click on the solid color button, and then click okay. Now for the fill color, I'm gonna change it to red. So I'm just gonna slide this value up in the top right corner. And then I'm gonna disable the stroke. So I'm gonna click on stroke and disable it, clicking on the hash and clicking okay. So now what I'm gonna do is hold down shift and click and draw out a perfect circle by clicking and dragging in the composition. I'm gonna let go. Once we have it, we can click off and we can see we have a nice new ellipse. And just to line this up, I am gonna zoom in so we can see a little bit better here by clicking Z on my keyboard. I'm gonna marquee select to zoom in here. And then I'm gonna grab my type tool. We'll click out once to create a new text layer. And you can name this anything. I'm gonna name it record, but you can change this to maybe camera one, camera two, whatever you want. I'm gonna select the text here. I'm gonna grab my selection tool. I'm just gonna align this here. Now to align this to each other, I'm gonna select both of them here. And what I'm gonna do is go to my align panel. I'm gonna change it to selection. I'm just gonna center by clicking this button right here. I believe it is aligned vertically. So now they are vertically aligned to each other. All right, so now that we have that, let's see how to loop this. So first we have to set up the animation of the blinking red light. So to do that, I'm gonna click on the layer in the timeline, click T to bring up opacity. I'm gonna click and make a keyframe by clicking on the stopwatch. You can leave it start at 100 or you could start at 0. In my template down in the video description, I started at 0. And we'll go out 15 frames. So I'm just going to change my time code to 15. And then I'm going to bring it up to 100. And then I'm going to go forward to 1 second. So if we zoom in here on our timeline, we'll go out forward to 1 second. And then we'll change it back down to 0. So now essentially we have this blinking animation. We can fine tune the animation a little bit. We can add some easy ease. That's what I did. I'm going to right click on the keyframe and go to easy ease, just to ease in a little bit more. It looks a little bit more natural. And then to loop this animation, what we're going to do is hover over the stopwatch, hold down option and click to bring up the expression controls menu. And then we're going to click this arrow. This will bring up all the expressions for keyframes. What we're going to do is navigate to property and then find the loop out type cycle num keyframe 0, this option right here. Once you click on that, this will fill in that box. You'll just want to click out. And now when we play this back, you can see that it loops out for infinity. So this is a nice way, instead of trying to copy and paste keyframes over and over again, this is a good way to loop keyframes. All right, so now that we have the time code, the border, the record light, let's see to add and create that battery life icon. So to create the battery, I'm first going to create the outline. And to do that, I'm going to use the rounded rectangle tool. This will add the roundness option to our controls. So if we click that, what I'm going to do is disable stroke, and then I'm going to disable it, click OK, and then enable the stroke again. So I'm going to click on that once more, click OK, leave it at 4 pixels. Like I said, you can customize this if you want it thinner or thicker. But next, what we have to do is actually zoom in here. And what I do want to do is make sure that it is on the same horizontal line or axis of the record light. So what I am going to do is just enable my rulers by hitting Command R, and then I'm going to zoom in to around the record button. I'm just going to click and drag this down. That way we have a guide and we can kind of base our design of the battery light to this horizontal guide. Next, I'm going to zoom out, and then I'm just going to move over to the other side here. I'm going to zoom in, and then I'm going to re-grab my rounded rectangle tool, and now we can get started. So I'm just going to click and draw out kind of like a rounded rectangle similar to a battery size. That looks good. We can reposition this by clicking P on our keyboard. I'm just going to bring up the Y. That way it aligns to our guide there. It's probably right about there is good. I'm going to move this over. Now to adjust the roundness, what I'm going to do is just twirl down underneath our layer, go to Contents, go into Side Rectangle, going into Rectangle Path. You'll notice that there's a new roundness option. So you can decrease this if you want less round, or more round if you want more round. But I found that maybe 15 is a good, decent roundness. Then one other thing that I do want to add is the nipple for the battery. So to do that, I'm just going to go back to my Rectangle tool. I'm going to enable the solid color, and then disable stroke once again, and then change the fill color to white. And before I draw that out, I do want to rename this battery outline. That way I just know this is the battery outline. All right, and now that we have that, I'm gonna click off of that and just click and draw out a nice little battery conductor side, the long side. I don't know technically what that's called, but you get the idea that this is kind of looking like a battery here. And then I'm going to rename that. So I'm going to rename this battery connector, or whatever the technical term is. All right, so now that we have the outline, kind of the trace of it, we need to create the shape layer or the fill that goes inside of it. I'm going to show you one pretty cool trick here in After Effects to do that. What I'm going to do is actually duplicate the battery outline layer. So I'm going to click on that and hit Command D to duplicate it. Then I'm going to rename it battery fill. That way we know this is the fill of the battery. And then what I'm going to do is enable fill. So we're going to click back on that, click solid color, click OK, and then disable the stroke. So no stroke. And then we're going to change the fill to green or whatever color that you want. In most cases, it's green on most cameras. You could do white or a different color. And then I'm going to twirl down. And then one thing we're going to add to this fill layer to get the effect that it's inside that outline is a offset paths value, and that's by clicking on this little arrow here. You can add an offset paths, and now that we have that, we can twirl down and then just slide the amount to the left to bring it in. You'll notice that we kind of punch in and give it like a inside stroke, or we're kind of clipping the outside bounds and bringing it in more or less. So that's how to get that effect. and then to actually animate it or possibly decrease the value, what I did is I clicked on the layer and I'm gonna actually move the anchor point. And to do that, I'm gonna grab the pan behind tool, which is right there. And then I'm just gonna click and drag this to the left while holding down command. And this will snap it to the edge, as you can see there. And now that we have it over there, what we can do is click on the layer, click S to bring up scale. And once again, we're gonna unlink the scale value. That way we can control each one separately. And we can click and drag the X one to the left. Now you can see that our anchor point is a little too far. So we can just zoom in here, grab our hand tool, and just kind of slide over. We'll reset this to 100. And I'm just gonna drag the pan from behind tool right to the edge of the green. So it's really, really close to the green. And that way, when we scale this down, it goes right to the edge. So you can see kind of how that works. That's a good way if you wanted to decrease the battery over time, you know, you could maybe possibly, you know, zoom out here, maybe make a keyframe on the scale, go out to 10 seconds, and then change the X value to 0, then the battery or the camera died. So let's see how that looks. You don't necessarily have to animate it, but that's one way that you could if you wanted to. In my template down below, I didn't animate it. I just kind of left it normal. That way it's more versatile. You can just change the battery level by just changing the X value. All right, so now that we have our record button and the battery level, the border and the time code, last thing we can add is maybe some text down below to kind of give it the look like it's a camera viewfinder. And really all I did is just add a text layer. You can actually duplicate the record layer as well. So I'll just click on that, hit Command D, click and drag this up to the top. And then I'll just bring up P to bring up position. And we'll just move this down. One thing you'll have to do is just change the character or the paragraph, make sure it's left aligned for the left side here. And you can just rename it anything you want here. I'm gonna rename it 4K Ultra HD 29.97. frames per second. And one thing I do want to align it to the blinking light. So to do that, I'm just going to go to the blinking light, which is down below. I'm going to click U and go to that keyframe once it's on the screen there. I'm going to click and draw out a guide to kind of get that. Then I'm just going to click and drag this text layer to that corner. That way it kind of looks lined up here. All right, so once that's there, I'm just going to click on this layer. I'm going to duplicate it one more time and we'll do the other side. I'm gonna click and drag it to the other side, change the paragraph alignment to right aligned, and just continue to click and drag to the right. And for this, we can just change it to maybe the white balance or different camera settings, different things like that. You can put in your own settings. But essentially, that's how to get that effect. I'm gonna disable title action safe and hide my rulers by hitting Command semicolon. And now we can see our finished design. So that's how to create a camera viewfinder inside Adobe After Effects. If you do want to see more After Effects tutorials or several on my channel, I'll link one that you might like right up there. But otherwise, I hope you have fun today creating this, and we'll see you guys next time. Thanks so much for watching.